Hey Trojans, hope you have all had a great week so far. I'm Brooke Hollers. Sit back, relax, and get ready for a bright new NBC show.
Coming up on this week's show, we meet this year's Marist top teens, take a look at the bright season ahead of the girls' basketball team, and shine some light on holiday shopping. All that and more on this glowing new episode of the Mayfield Broadcast.
Every year, the mayor picks the city's brightest teens for mayor's top teens. For more on that, here's Roxy.
Here at Mayfield, we have a lot of bright students. Some of them have even become mayor's top teens. Mrs. Boyce, who nominated some of this year's teens, explains more.
When I nominate someone for mayor's top teens, I look for someone who is involved in the community, who's been involved in community service events, as well as involved in school activities. Also someone who has overcome some type of obstacle in their life, whether that's been from the death of a loved one who inspired them to do well in school, or to someone who has overcome a great illness.
Many students have been chosen, but 19 out of 41 are from Mayfield. Here they are, this year's Mayor's Top Teens. This year's teens feel truly honored to be chosen as Mayor's Top Teens.
It feels really great to be recognized for all the hard work I have put in all of my high school years and even before that.
It's awesome to be recognized by the mayor and then just throughout the town of, you know, for accomplishments that you've done.
All of this year's Mayor's Top Teens have proved that hard work pays off. This has been Roxy for NBC. Okay.
The Lady Trojans have been working really hard right in this gym, and they definitely have a bright season ahead of them. For more on that, here's this week's Trojan Sports.
With coming into the season as 2013 state runner-ups, the Lady Trojans are ready for a bright season. With impressive previous records, the girls have been working hard both on and off the court. They continue to show improvement game by game, and with state already on their minds, they are up for a bright season. Captains Allie Pierce, Dejana McCants, and Alyssa Rojas give us an insight on how they feel as being captain, their responsibilities, and their goals for this season.
Feels great to be a captain and know that so many younger girls are looking up to me.
It's an honor to be a captain and a privilege in my opinion because it's somebody that everybody looks up to.
It feels good to be a captain even though sometimes it can be stressful.
And are to lead on and off the court my team and help keep them motivated and going strong. This season, our team goal is to win district and to take state.
I think we're going to accomplish our goals and do our best and end up in that state championship game again.
My personal goals this season are to help get us to state.
We have to keep our team together, make sure everyone's doing their part on and off the court.
They are ready to battle it out and conquer everything and any team that comes their way. The girls sure do show passion, dedication, and love for the game. Their next battle is this Saturday at 5 p.m. against Carlsbad. Make sure you go out and support the ladies as they conquer their opponents. This has been Gloria for NBC Sports.
I can't wait to see what you girls can accomplish this season. And another thing I can't wait for is the holidays. But with holidays comes a whole lot of shopping. For more on shopping during the holidays, here's Alessandra.
Holiday shopping season is here again, and with it comes tons of sales. This year alone, over 135 million people went Black Friday shopping, which is actually lower than the usual. Even though less people went shopping this year, those who were out there spent an average $64 more than last year, and shoppers spent 11% more Thanksgiving weekend this year than they did in 2012. Overall, Black Friday was a success, and those who went shopping got all the sales.
My experience was... it was okay. It was alright. It was just some people that you need to watch out with because there is some shoving and pushing going on.
Some Mayfield students have been taking advantage of working in retail as well as getting the sales.
A lot of stores have been opening earlier and closing later due to the holiday season. I myself have been earning a lot of hours lately.
Black Friday was huge, but the sales online were even bigger. This year was the biggest Cyber Monday in history, reaching a record $1.735 billion in online spending. The holiday season is here again, and next year the sales may be even better. This has been Alessandra for NBC.
There are many bright students here at Mayfield, so bright that a few have received the National Hispanic Merit Scholarship. For more on that, here's Serena and Erin.
The Hispanic National Merit Scholarship is for Hispanic students that score in the top 2% of the nation on the PSAT their junior year. In order to get this scholarship, you must have at least one quarter Hispanic or Latino descent.
I'm a National Merit Scholar. It took a lot of hard work and studying through my years of high school.
There's just a lot of studying involved. You know, over summer I took a test like every day during summer, and then, you know, during the school week, I took a test like on the weekends, but just studying a lot really helped.
Right now I'm taking mostly AP classes and a math class at the university.
I've always taken honors ever since being in high school, and I take AP classes ever since my junior year and this year.
Sarah and Megan are not only devoted to their studies, but are also involved in many extracurricular activities outside of school.
And well, National Honor Society, French Club, and SAD during school, and then I'm also in orchestra and symphony.
I'm in National Honor Society and Key Club, and I'm also a ballerina at Michelle Dance Academy.
In order to receive this scholarship, students must have a GPA of 3.0 or higher by the end of their junior year. When awarded this scholarship, tuition, room, board, books, and other fees are paid for.
It just really validates all of the hard work that I've put in through high school and like shows what I've done.
It's just really great because I've put in so much work during high school and all my classes and studying and whatnot, so it just feels good to have all that pay off.
Congratulations to Sarah and Megan. Way to represent Mayfield in a bright way. This has been Erin and Serena for NBC News.
Students, I hope you all have a bright holiday break. We'll see you next year. This has been Brooke for NBC. So good, come on.